just do your best to keep us in frame.
Okay.
You know, and if you want to get him at the bottom and then follow him up to get me, that's fine, because I'm going to have me first person.
I'm not going to get anybody in the bottom, Jimmy.
Welcome back, everybody. I'm Jimmy Nutt from Run Gun Nation. We started off 2022 in a great fashion. Got to attend the Gun Run Team Edition down at Sawmill Training Complex in Lawrence, South Carolina. So the first thanks, of course, goes out to Ellis for hosting a fantastic match. You put on six great stages, nice little 5K event with the addition of the obstacle course that you'll see here in the beginning. It turned out fantastic. The second thanks, of course, goes out to Steve, the owner and proprietor of Sawmill Training Complex. Fantastic facility. You hosted us, ROs, competitors, and all the staff and everybody that got to attend the team match. Thanks again, Steve. The next big thanks goes out to John, my teammate. We had another fantastic time doing a team running gun, just like the very first one we stepped off on. And then, of course, thank you to Matt and Tony, my friends from Virginia that enjoyed the drive down to Lawrence with me and endured the suck as a team too fat, none furious. And the next thanks goes out to Scott. Thanks very much, Scott, for putting together these awesome t-shirts for both me and John with team two dogs in a bathtub. And then again for Matt and Tony for team too fat, none furious. Love the shirts. So thanks again, Scott. The next thanks, of course, goes out to all the other ROs that joined us on Friday. We had fantastic weather, and then we got to endure the suck of the cold all day Saturday. And of course, the next thanks goes out to all the competitors that showed up and endured the suck of all that cold on Saturday. Another big shout out to a fellow photographer out on the course, and that's Lisa, Matt's wife. You did an awesome job with your photos. I'm going to use a whole bunch of these during this video. So thanks again, Lisa, for taking awesome photos of all of us. Couldn't do this without you. I love taking photos while I'm out there. But again, like I said in previous videos, I can only be in one place at one time. So having Lisa out there, you made it even better and caught more of the competitors and the ROs on film so that we could memorialize this fantastic event. We'll talk a little bit about the course and the guns and the gear and everything that I ran, and then we'll get right into the video footage. So the course was, we measured it between 3.9 or 2.99 miles all the way up to like 3.24 miles, depending on whose GPS was running and how it was going. So it was right around 3 miles, maybe a little bit more than 3 miles of another great course at Sawmill. So, we had six stages of fire that varied from rifle and rifle to rifle and pistol, challenging. You'll get to see all this stuff. Me and John did a good job. We only DNF'd one stage. That was stage one, and that DNF was all my fault. You'll get to see that here in the video. I even pointed out as to why, you know, that's why my mistakes cost us that stage and gave us a DNF. But everything else, we did fantastic. We placed really good on a couple of the stages, especially the long range stage. I think we got eighth place overall. That's enough about the course. We'll go into the guns and the gear and everything that I carried. All right, the first thing that I'll talk about in guns and gear is the guns that I used. So for rifle, I carried the KelTec RDB. All right, this is a 5.56, and it's got a T.A.50 ACOG on top. It used to have a T.A.31 ACOG on top of it, and I moved that over to the AR-15A4 that I built, so I got this T.A.50 and put it on there. It's another three-power ACOG. It did fantastic. We had sighted it in with the 77 grain IMI razor core that I use, and the gun loves this stuff. So it's got a little grip pod on the end, you can see that, and that helped me on the long range stage. It kind of screwed me up a bit on the first stage. You'll get to see that. So fun little gun to shoot. I didn't carry it on this sling. I'm just wearing the sling right now for the video. I carried it using the T.A.B Biathlon sling, which allowed me to sling it on my back the entire time. And it did great as usual. All right, so for pistol, all right, you guys know that I love my M&P. So I carried the M&P long slide. We could run the pistols hot during the course. So I had one magazine in the pistol. And then on my belt, I had three other 22 round Smith & Wesson M&P magazines in this HSGI Taco. And then we had the HSGI Tacos carrying three 30 round AR mags for the RDB. And last but not least, I have the iPhone 13 Pro Max that's videotaping me right now. And that's what I used for the third person view in most of the time. And then I had my Hero 8 Black. And then John had his Hero 8 Black. So again, why it's taken me a week to actually process this is I was playing the game of doing post-production with three cameras. So picking the best angle, having the iPhone 13 Pro Max, and then two GoPro Hero 8s out there, and then trying to capture everything. It was challenging, but I think it turned out well. So you guys let me know. And I tried to make sure that, you know, what I was doing in the video, if it was a split screen or an inset or whatever it was, is I'm not giving you the viewers like some sort of vertigo or shit like that when you're trying to watch to see what's happening. So hopefully I've edited this so that you guys can see how I captured me and John out on the course, him shooting, me shooting, when us shooting at the same time, and how that all worked, and the challenges and the physical things that we had to do in between. So I think I did a pretty good job. I think that's it for the course, the guns and the gear. I get a lot of thanks, of course. We'll revisit those, and that's Ellis and Steve. Thank you very much. Okay. John for joining me, Matt and Tony for coming out and joining us again. I talked about the ROs, I talked about the other competitors that showed up, talked about Lisa. Thanks again for all the fantastic photos. And last, I forgot to mention, of course, our sponsors, you know, Mike from Crate Tactical and all the folks that come out there and put awesome stuff on the table that folks got to walk away with. I think that's pretty much it for the intro to this video. So I'll get right into the GoPro / iPhone 13 Pro Max footage that we shot while we're out there. You guys enjoy, and until the next time, Jimmy Nutt from Run and Gun Nation, I'll see you guys out. Am I good?
Yep. This is way lighter than the last time we did this.
You don't take away the same.
Notice John took the woman's one. I was talking to the camera.
Shooter one, your target array is that white reduced IMSIC target straight in the wood line, straight out. You see it?
Yep.
All right, here's your port. First port is going to be bottom right triangle. Second port will be upper right or upper left, right here.
Three hits each port.
Three hits each port. Shooter two, go ahead and stand by right there.
Thank you.
like that for me?
Oh, man.
Here's your sheet, Jimmy, right here. Bottom right.
Watch your muzzle. Ground it up here on this truck. And it's behind the target. Call it here.
Sorry.
Here he is.
You're high left, high right, high right.
Grounded.
John, you got shot in the leg. Go ahead on the ground. Jimmy, apply the tourniquet right here.
Okay.
Right here.
Which leg? Either one?
Right leg.
Okay.
A little bit higher, a little bit higher.
Yep, there yep. You go. He's got his phone in there. I'm not going to crush his phone.
That's good, that's good, that's good. One twist
one
and lock it and put the Velcro in.
There.
All right, we'll do a Velcro.
Oh,
all right, get your own, help him over into the slide, however y'all want to do it. Just extract this.
Leg.
All right. Go ahead and drag him. Pass these two locks here all the way through. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Good. Draw you right here. Draw your pistol. Two hits. Hit. That's it. Make your pistol how you want it. You're done.
The far one in the back, right?
Yes, sir. Nice. 6350. Unknown chauffeur.
Ready?
Yep.
Stand by. Ready?
Yep.
Take it.
Got it. Left-handed.
Target,
stick to the left. Right here?
Yep.
Hit.
Hit.
Left-handed. Damn it. Give it here. I got it. Go, 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 go. Come on. Go, go, go. Fucking A.
I'm gonna walk this bitch up there. Well, I already have it in my silver.
Thank you, Jimmy.
141.05. So just 141.
Damn it.
Smile for the camera. Smile for the camera. You saved little Timmy.
I've got a shotgun tongue that tick like a time bomb, all black everything. I've got a switchblade with the cuts like a bitch, and I think you too should need. I wanna break free from my humanity.
One. Okay, is that it?
Oh.
You got a close one, a far one, and one to the right. Three hits.
He's low.
Yeah, you got three.
One for more.
6831.
Good job, John. We don't have really a lot of time for me to do the whole after action stick thing, so maybe we'll sit around the fire with a fucking whiskey and we'll do that then with the other team, Too Fat and Unfurious. Two dogs in a bathtub coming in. If you haven't looked that up on Google, please do.
Yay, 1239.4.
Good course. Man.